praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His aid, and we ask for His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah misguides, none can guide. And I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah alone, who has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and His messenger. Brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode of your show, Treasures of the Past, and I'm your host, Moutasem Al-Hameedi. We are still dealing with situations and stories from the past which show and demonstrate to us the beauty of Al-Iman and how Iman can improve our lives and can help us attain paradise. One of the things and the greatest bounties Allah has ever given mankind is something called At-Tawakkul. Relying upon Allah. This is a great treasure. And this is a strong weapon with which we can face the hardships and the difficulties and the challenges throughout our lives. It's a beautiful thing to have, and it's a beautiful feeling that the person has in his heart. When you rely upon Allah, who has power over everything, when you rely upon Allah, the creator of the heavens and the earth, when you rely upon Allah, the only one who deserves to be worshipped, then your heart is in peace. Your heart is in tranquility. You are not taken by different sorts of fear or worries and concerns, because you entrust everything to Allah and you become content with everything Allah wrote for you. This is a beautiful treasure, but because the Muslims at this day and this age, their Iman has fallen down. The level of Iman has gone down. Then their tawakkul, their reliance upon Allah has become weak. And this is why they can't find the sweetness of this beautiful characteristic at tawakkul, of this beautiful weapon with which we can face the difficulties and the hardships in this life. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear to us in different verses throughout the Quran that we should have tawakkul. We should have reliance upon Allah, and Allah loves the one who rely on Him. It shows that you trust Allah. It shows that you know the true worth of Allah. It shows that you understand the power of Allah. It shows that your heart is attached to Allah. It's not attached to this world. You know that Allah has power over everything. So it is a clear demonstration of Al-Iman. If you don't have sincere Iman in your heart, you won't have tawakkul, because tawakkul is a natural result and outcome of having firm belief and Iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every day or every rak'ah we pray, at least the Muslim prays 17 rak'ahs a day. In each rak'ah you say, Iyaka na'bud wa Iyaka nasta'een. You say to Allah, O Allah, it is You we worship, and it's Your help that we seek. When you seek the help of Allah, it means you depend upon Allah. You have tawakkul upon Allah and you rely on Allah. And this is the religion of Al-Islam. Notice, we can summarize the religion of Al-Islam by worshipping Allah, Iyaka na'bud. It's only You that we worship, and it's only Your help that we seek. Wa Iyaka nasta'een. So if you worship Allah and you seek the help of Allah and you rely upon that, then you are a believer and you are a Muslim, and you will lead a very beautiful life. You will be strong and firm. You will be brave. You will be content and happy in this world. And on the Day of Judgment, you will deserve the pleasure of Allah and all the reward that Allah has prepared for the believers who have real tawakkul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those who have believed and they do righteous deeds, لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُم مِّنَ الْجَنَّةِ غُرَفًا. We shall give them from paradise, or in paradise, rooms and chambers. تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Flow, and they will dwell there forever. نِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. What a beautiful reward for the ones who did righteousness. And what are the characteristics of these people? الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Those who had patience and they depend and they rely on their Lord. You see where tawakkul takes you? It helps you in this life and it helps you in the second to attain paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set a high position for the ones who achieve reliance upon Him. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there will be 70,000 people from the nation of Muhammad, from Ummah Muhammad, who will enter paradise without account, without being held to account, and without punishment at all. And these people, when he said that to this statement to the companions, they said, "Who are these, O Messenger of Allah?" They started discussing amongst themselves who these people might be. Some of them said, maybe these are the ones who were with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam all the time, and they went through all the hardships and difficulties at the beginning of the da'wah. Some of them said, maybe they are the ones who were born in Islam and they had no shirk at all. Some of them said, maybe they are the ones who did this or did that. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to them, "What are you talking about?" They said, "We are discussing who are the ones or the 70,000 who will enter paradise without account and without punishment." So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to them, "They are the ones who do not ask for ruqya. They do not go to someone to recite Quran or dua on them. They do not seek that. But if it comes to them, it's okay. But they don't say to someone, 'Make ruqya upon me.'" That's the first description. The second one, لا يتطيرون. They do not believe in bad omen. They do not believe in bad omen. And the third one, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. They depend upon their Lord. They rely on Allah. And tawakkul is an action of the heart. So your heart is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah will help you fulfill the things you want to do while you are doing the necessary things that you have to do. For example, you want to make a living. You know that provision comes from Allah. It doesn't come from your employer. It doesn't come from anyone else. It comes from Allah. But Allah told you to take the necessary means, so you go and work. If you want some water, you go and bring some water. You go and bring that water, but your heart is attached to Allah. You go to the doctor in order to treat an illness. You believe that Allah is the one who will cure you. It comes from Allah. Your heart is attached to Allah. It's not attached to the doctor. But the doctor is only the necessary means that you follow, because Allah commanded you to do so. You see how beautiful al-Iman is? When you depend upon Allah, you don't fear anyone. You don't fear anything. You don't worry about anything. You entrust Allah with everything. And you have a tranquil life. I depend upon Allah. So you see, the ones who have true Iman, when they have the tawakkul, they are very confident. Because they don't depend upon themselves. They don't depend upon somebody else. They depend upon Allah. So their hearts are at rest. They're happy, they're content. Whatever Allah writes down, I'm happy with that. I'm content with that. And I depend upon Allah. If my intention is sincere, Allah will help me. As long as I have tawakkul and I rely upon Allah, then Allah will give me everything. And in the Quran, we can notice that التوكل is a sign of al-Iman. As Allah said in the Quran, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَتَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. And upon Allah, depend and rely if you are truly believers. If you are believers, then depend upon Allah, because it's a natural consequence of believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And let the believers rely upon Allah. And Allah narrated about the believers that they say, قُلْ هُوَ الرَّحْمَانُ آمَنَّا بِهِ وَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا. Say, He is Ar-Rahman, the Merciful. آمَنَّا بِهِ. We believe in Him. وَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا. And upon Him we rely. So this is how the believers should be. And this is what Iman gives us. It gives us strength. And we mentioned in previous episodes that the bravest people are the believers. The strongest people are the believers. The most steadfast are the believers. Why? Because they rely upon Allah. The hearts are attached to Allah, so they know everything is in the hands of Allah and is within the power and the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they are attached to Allah and they are happy with that. And Allah described the believers in the Quran. He said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The believers are the ones when the remembrance of Allah, when the name of Allah is mentioned, the hearts become fearful. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. And when His verses are recited upon them, they increase in al-Iman. These verses will increase their Iman. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. They rely and they depend upon their Lord. You see why the Muslim is strong and he's firm and is brave and is honest? Because he depends upon Allah. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. They are the ones who establish the prayer and they give in charity from what we've provided for them. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ. The ones who have these characteristics, they are the believers truly. The true believers are the ones who have these characteristics. لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. They will have high position in the sight of Allah and they will be granted forgiveness and an honorable provision from Allah. So the one who depends upon Allah, he doesn't fear anyone. He lives a life of tranquility, a life of peace, a life of contentment, happiness that Allah grants him. You see why the believers have happiness? The disbelievers, their hearts are not attached to Allah. So everything they do when they set up business, they're concerned about the success of their business. They do something, they're worried, and they are under distress until they get the final results. And they spend their lives that way. All the time they are attached to the materialistic things. They are not attached to Allah. But the Muslim, he does or he follows the necessary means because Allah commanded him to do so. But his heart is with Allah. So the Muslim is brave, is strong, is happy and content with the decree of Allah. And the believers and the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are the ones who achieved real tawakkul. And we saw how they fought the disbelievers, although they were very little in number. And they faced a massive army in the battle of Badr. But Allah gave them victory because their hearts were not attached to weapons and to numbers. They were attached to Allah. When they had real iman, real reliance upon Allah, Allah gave them victory. So when we look at the state of the Muslims today and we say we are weak, we don't have the necessary means, we don't have the power, and we don't have the armies and the military power and preparations. Victory is not related to these things. There is the foundation for all that. The foundation is real iman. When we achieve al-iman and we implement al-Islam and we rely upon Allah, don't worry about the weapons. They will come. All the power the disbelievers have, it will come to you. Don't worry about that. But let your heart be attached to Allah, only to Allah. Achieve that reliance upon Allah and you see how victory will be for the Muslims, not the disbelievers. Because the disbelievers' hearts are attached to the materialistic things. If something goes wrong, they will lose. But the believer's heart is attached to Allah. And this is why the believers and even the prophets before that, they were attached to Allah. They faced their enemies. They faced their people who were powerful with all bravery and all courage. And they were firm upon their iman. Why? Because they were dependent upon Allah. They relied upon Allah. They were happy with the decree of Allah. That's it. You see what iman does to the person? We know that the prophets, they faced their people. And they were so powerful. But every time they were open and then publicly they declared the truth and they invited their people to al-iman. And they faced the harm with reliance upon Allah. Now we will see how we can benefit from that, and we'll see good examples, beautiful examples about tawakkul and how this can benefit us. But now we will have a short break, so stay tuned.
Who should you marry? When is it time for divorce? I want my children to love Islam, but I don't know how. The Quran and Sunnah has the answer to these questions and more. To find out what those answers are, check out Family Issues and see the difference clear guidance makes.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back. This is Moutasem Al-Hameedi. You're still watching Treasures of the Past. Now, we came to understand how reliance upon Allah makes the Muslim strong and brave as his heart is attached to the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Now, if someone was attached or he had the support of a strong power, he would feel all-powerful and he would feel courage and confidence and all that. So what about the person who is attached to the one who has control over everything? The one under whose power everything goes. So this is the case of the believer. This is why when a person is a mu'min, is a real believer, he doesn't fear anyone. He doesn't fear anything as his heart is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's see some beautiful examples. The first one is the Prophet of Allah, Hud. May peace and blessings be upon him. Now he depended upon Allah and he came to his people, the people of Ad. They were the strongest of people at that time. And Allah said about them, أَلَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. The likes of them were not created ever because they were very strong. He challenged his people and he invited them to the religion of Islam. And they tried to scare him with their gods, with their false deities. But he was firm and strong. And he said to them, as Allah says, قَالَ إِنِّي أُشْهِدُ اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. He said to them, I ask Allah to witness, and you as well bear witness, that I am free from everything you worship, everything you associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِن دُونِهِ فَكِيدُونِي جَمِيعًا. Anything you associate with Allah, then I'm free from that. So plot against me, plan against me, I don't care, whatever you do. Inni tawakkaltu ala Allahi Rabbi. You see the weapon of the believer, wherever he goes, whoever he's dealing with. Inni tawakkaltu ala Allahi Rabbi wa Rabbikum. I have depended, I have relied upon Allah, my Lord and your Lord. You see, his people were powerful, but he was confident. He challenged them, I have depended upon my Lord and your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا مِن دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ آخِذٌ بِنَاصِيَتِهَا. There's no creature except that it is under his control. And the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of generations. Now they set a very beautiful example for all of us to see. After the battle of Uhud, when the Muslims, we can say relatively, they were defeated. And many of them were killed. Many of them were wounded. So when they were on the way back to Al-Madinah and the disbelievers have gathered themselves, the news came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the disbelievers gathered themselves and they wanted to invade Al-Madinah so that they could annihilate the Muslims and root them out and get rid of them forever. So the news came that they were coming and the Muslims, many of them were wounded and psychologically they were in a very bad state. Let's see now, they were tired, they were defeated, psychologically tired, coming back to Al-Madinah, and the Kuffar, the victorious, they were coming to root them out and kill them. So, at that time, the Messenger ﷺ told them the news, and he said, we will go and fight them. So, the Prophet went out of Al-Madinah, they were coming to Al-Madinah, but now they changed the direction, and they were heading towards Al-Kuffar, they were ready to fight. Imagine that state. Well, if we are going to talk about about power and energy, would they really be able to fight? They have just been defeated by the same army. And now they are very tired, but they went to that army because their hearts were attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when they went out, the disbelievers anyway went back to Mecca and that war did not take place. Now, let's see what Allah says about the believers, how He praised them in that hard situation. He said, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ. Those are the ones whom the people, or to whom the people said that the other people, the disbelievers, have gathered a big army to fight you and to kill you. فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The people said to them, so fear them and be scared of them. So don't go to them. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. It increased them in al-Iman. Subhanallah. Hardship, but it makes them increase in al-Iman. This is how the believers, and this is how the ones who rely upon Allah. They know it is the promise of Allah, and anything Allah wrote for us, it will happen. So they went out to fight the disbelievers. And they said, وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. And they said, Allah is enough for us. And He is the one we rely upon. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ. So they returned. We know that the enemy of the Kuffar went back to Mecca. So the battle did not take place. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ. They returned back to Al-Madinah with a bounty from Allah and favor. لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. No harm came to them. وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ. And they followed the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَظِيمٍ. And Allah is of great bounty. So you see, they earned the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they relied upon Allah. And even though the situation was very hard, they relied upon Allah and they went to that battle. So reliance upon Allah, tawakkul, is the reason behind any success. is the reason behind strength and confidence is reliance and tawakkul. It is the weapon Allah granted His believers. And the disbelievers, they will never have that, because their hearts are attached, or their hearts are attached to this life and to the materialistic things that we see in this life. They are not attached to the Creator of the heavens and the earth. And Allah urged the Prophet ﷺ, and He said, فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. And if you decide a matter, or you make your mind up with regards to a matter, then تَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Rely upon Allah and do it. And then He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Allah loves the ones who have tawakkul, the ones who rely upon Him. And if Allah loves a person, then Allah will aid him. If Allah loves a person, He will make him enter paradise. If Allah loves a person, He will make the people love him. So don't worry about people's love and people's agreement to whatever you do. Rely upon Allah and victory will be yours. Happiness will be yours. Confidence will be yours. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, or Allah promised the ones who rely upon Him to provide for them without measure. There's a beautiful hadith that I want you to pay attention to and benefit from in your daily life when your means fall short and the financial situation gets hard and people start running around like headless chicken trying to take this or that. We don't know what to do. I want the help of that man. Some people resort to stealing, some people resort to riba and taking loans from banks and immersing themselves and their families in haram and impermissible things and in crime. When they fall in financial hardship, the Prophet ﷺ says, if you rely upon Allah as you should really do, Allah would provide for you just as He provides for birds. Let's contemplate and reflect upon the situation or the state of birds. Now birds, the Prophet ﷺ says, in the morning they leave with empty stomachs and they come in the evening full. Allah provides for them. Why? Because even animals and birds rely upon Allah. Why don't we do that? Because of al-Iman. If we lack al-Iman in our hearts, we will be in trouble. If we lack Iman in our hearts, we won't rely upon Allah. So if you rely upon Allah, Allah will provide for you. So what do you fear? Some people work or they have a job that has something of haram. And they say, I can't give up my job. Because of my children, I have to feed them, I have to buy a house, I have to get this, I have to get that. I can't abandon this job. It is haram, you're doing haram, you're promoting haram, you're selling haram. Fear Allah. Well, he says, I can't, I have to make a living. But where is reliance upon Allah? If you rely upon Allah, you will give it up and Allah will give you something better, because the Prophet ﷺ promised that. He said, anyone who leaves anything for the sake of Allah, Allah will recompense him with something better. So why don't we rely upon Allah? People rely upon the power they have, upon the wealth they have, but we don't rely upon Allah. Why is that? It shows there is a weakness of our certainty in the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is weakness in al-Iman that is in our hearts. Now, let's see how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam urged us to rely upon Allah. But before that, you see how the Muslims sometimes, when they fall in financial hardship, they resort to banks, they resort to haram. Why is that? Because of the weakness of al-Iman. Weakness of tawakkul and reliance upon Allah. This is why Allah makes the situation hard for them and worse for them, because they don't have reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People resort to insurance companies because they don't have belief in the decree of Allah and they don't depend upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah increases them in hardship and Allah makes situations worse for them. And if you depend upon Allah, Allah will protect you from shaitan. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that if the person, when he leaves his house, he says, Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You know the dua when you leave your house? In the name of Allah, I rely upon Allah, and there's no power, no might, except with Allah. It will be said to him. It means from Allah. Hudita, you have been guided. Wa kufita wa wuqita, you have been protected, and you have been saved the pain of any harm that will come to you, and shaitan will turn away from him. So once you rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaitan will have no power over you. Now, Jabir is saying that at one time, when we were coming or going to a battle, the Prophet ﷺ rested under the shade of a tree. So a kafir came to him. He sneaked and he came to the Prophet. The Prophet was hanging his sword to the tree. So the man got hold of the sword of the Prophet and he put it above the head of the Prophet. And he said to him, "Ya Muhammad, who protects you from me?" The Messenger ﷺ was under the sword. And he looked at him and he said, "Allah." You see the honor. You see the reliance upon Allah. The man could kill him, but he said, "Allah protects me from you." So the sword fell down from the hand of the disbeliever. And the Prophet ﷺ took hold of it. And he said to the man, "Who protects you from me?" He said, "No one." He said to the Prophet ﷺ, "Take it easy, O Muhammad." So the Prophet ﷺ said to him, "Do you bear witness that no one deserves to be worshipped except Allah and that I am the messenger of Allah?" The man said, "No." The Prophet ﷺ could kill him. The man said, "No." But he said, "I give you my word that I will not fight you and I will not be with anyone who will fight you." So the Messenger ﷺ let him go. The man went back to his people and he said, "I came to you from the best of creation, from the best of human beings." So now you see in this case how the Prophet ﷺ relied upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he didn't fear that man. Although the man could kill him with his sword, but he said, "Allah protects me from you," and Allah gave him victory. This is how we want to be. This is the beautiful example we want to follow. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawakkul and real reliance upon Him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all and bless us all and make us better Muslims. I have to leave you for the time being. And I say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.